We're here at our 2022 Patriot Hacks mixed with our Hack Overflow. I'm here with some of our OGs, the guys who started this all. It is surreal for us to come back and see this, first of all, this amazing new building that wasn't even here when we started. And then to see the fact that we've gone from having one hackathon to two. Very excited to give people the opportunity for STEM and the opportunity to kind of have that enrichment in that environment that's very creative mixed with your academia.
We are really working with innovators here who are using technology to solve problems.
So you have a bunch of challenges, you choose your challenge, and then you build an idea around what you're going to do to address that challenge.
They have been here since Friday evening, and they're working pretty hard.
I had to basically spend the entire night up working on this.
I've passed it. I'm so tired. I don't know what stress is anymore.
Caffeine is amazing.
I see so many students pick up projects and pick up different types of technologies that they haven't touched previously.
We're using like Android Studio and none of us have used that before, so we're learning as we went.
Yeah, I was able to learn like new stuff that I didn't do before because I'm a bio major.
A lot of people who came to this hackathon, not many of them were engineers. We had a lot of bio majors and fashion majors, business majors. It's really, if you have the passion to work on, you know, something crazy, our focus is to give you that opportunity to make that vision a reality.
If we thread the wires through here, we won't be able to open it.
That makes sense, yeah, go for it.
I think there was a lot of excitement from the student body that there was going to be a hardware hackathon in general, because there is a hardware track for Patriot Hacks, but that's not their focus.
We initially thought we were going to finish this in a few hours, like yesterday. Turns out they stayed here till like 1 a.m. to finish this. We had a few things that we had to change about our concept.
The fact that it's a very concentrated window of time for the event creates a very interesting dynamic. You know, Salesforce actually does 3 releases every year, and it's on a very specific time frame that's actually told to our customers well in advance, and so it's giving the students a taste of what that is like.
So the time limit is definitely scary at first, but once you actually get a good holding on like what your project is and you build a good foundation as we did, it gets easier with time.
Our 4 minds like debugging the issues before coding it saved us a lot of time, like actually debugging while coding it.
As long as you have a game plan, you're good to go. The rest is actually just enjoying yourself while you do your work.
It takes manpower to run this event, and it takes a team of really dedicated students. They're always willing to find solutions. They're definitely all go-getters.
The amount of people who sign up versus the amount of people who submit, it's always a gamble. And so when you see all the projects rolling in at the submission, and you get to see all the judges getting excited to be judging these projects, it's really exciting just to see it all come together.
About 10 minutes before the deadline, there was about like 10, and now there's upwards of about 21 submissions.
Obviously, in this type of event, we're not expecting to get some type of finished product level grade thing, right? We're expecting instead to see what's the merit of their idea, how are they able to execute on that. We want to see what their vision is, because sometimes the vision can also be really compelling.
It was pretty eye-opening, seeing the students' degree of work and the difficulty that they're working on, applying it to real world problems was quite meaningful.
Parkinson's patients, they cannot control their hand correctly to the direction that they want it. So we wanted to create an automation glove.
From the bottom of the stack to the top of the stack, we're using a ton of different technologies. And we even switched between different languages for certain components.
Presenting was interesting. It was a lot of explanation of what we were trying to do and how we were going to implement it.
It's like a stress relief because it's like you've done all this work and you finally get to show it to them.
They give us improvements. We can make those changes next time when we make a design for a new project.
What I saw here was a diverse range of solutions to a very complex problem. Normally you would see one type of approach that it would be the same across the board. This, the students took it in all different directions and the results were very impressive.
I liked the presentation more than the process because I learned so much more just from presenting and the feedback we were getting. Like the fact that we could turn our project into a research idea for like the Office of Sustainability at Mason, like I think that's just mind-blowing. And we didn't even have that initially as a thought. Now we think this could become a research project.
This is the real world. Many students may be discovering there's so much to be offered outside of the classroom, that there are really opportunities to do things maybe that they never thought that they could do before, and to discover that they're ready.